While responding to audit queries quoted by the Auditor General's report for the year ended June 2022, MPs on the Public Accounts Committee asked officials from the Ministry of Public Service to explain why some public servants are paid more than one pension from the Consolidated Fund and what remedies have been put in place to end this practice.
Kwizera is the speaker here. He retires as a speaker with pension. He becomes the vice president of Uganda. He also qualifies to have pension. You know the pension means vehicles and everything.
You know, you've made a point. I was a deputy speaker, I retire pension.
Yes.
I become a speaker, retire pension. I go vice president, I retire pension. Do you have more than
one
pension?
You are the human resource expert and planner.
You are paying irregularly.
Yes.
There is a law, but you see that there is something wrong with it because you cannot live in three houses at the same time.
Mm. And drive three cars at the same time. Have we written to Attorney General of that problem?
So the person who is implementing the law should be the first one to find fault in it.
Such public servants include former Vice President Edward Chiwanuka Sekandi, who is entitled to three pension packages for the three top positions he held, including Vice President, Speaker of Parliament, and Deputy Speaker of Parliament. Another is the first Deputy Prime Minister, Rebecca Kadaga, who also served as Speaker and Deputy Speaker. MPs questioned the rationale of giving these officials cards for each office with fuel and wondered when they get time to sit in these cars at the same time.
You cannot get more than one pension from one consolidated what? Fund. I think you'll be right to the account, the Attorney General and the copiers.
That way expenditure comes in. How do you put fuel for Kwizera, who is retired as a speaker, and you give him a driver at the same time in another car?
Thank you, Chair. Yes, we do. And those are prescribed by the law. They are separate laws that are relating to separate provisions. But if an individual, by the grace of God, has been through all those positions, then the law applies to him in the separate contexts.
In the financial year under review, the Ministry of Public Service spent 6.8 billion shillings on emoluments paid to former presidents, vice presidents, and prime ministers. The former vice president is entitled to housing allowance of 300 million shillings annually, 370 million shillings in car, 10 million shillings every 5 years for purchase of furniture, a monthly pension of 6.7 million shillings, translating to 80.4 million shillings annually, two police guards all paid 1.1 million shillings per month, 8.4 million shillings annually for utilities, two domestic servants paid a monthly salary of 696,000 amounting to 8.35 million shillings annually, and a senior personnel secretary allocated 10.8 million shillings annually. This prompted Nandala Mafabi, who chaired the meeting, to direct the ministry to seek legal guidance from the Attorney General on the matter.
Do, as a committee, have seen, give us those drafts you have made, number one. Two, the Committee of Public Accounts is directing you to write to the Attorney General to seek his opinion where somebody is earning more than one pension.
Meanwhile, the Bukimbiri County MP, Eddie Kwizera, lashed out at the Ministry of Public Service for paying President Yoweri Museveni a peanut salary of 3.6 million shillings, yet the permanent secretary earns 15.4 million shillings.
Madam PS, you can't pay the president of Uganda 3.6 million and you pay yourself 15.4 million.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.